Hello, I'm T.S. Rhodes, author, artist, and costumer. I've won awards for my pirate costumes, and today I'm going to teach you how to make an authentic 18th century shirt perfect for a pirate costume. Going to start off with between 4.5 and 5.5 yards of fabric. Today I'll be working with white fabric, but I wanted to show you one of my previous shirts. The check pattern shows that a pirate shirt is made out of a series of rectangles with a triangular gusset in the armpit. As I said, you're going to need between 4.5 and 5.5 yards of fabric. You want this to be a woven fabric, not a knit like a t-shirt fabric. It should be lightweight and comfortable. Muslin or calico is great. For this project, you will need a long straight edge, a marker of some kind, scissors, needle and thread, and pins. It also helps to have a shirt that fits the person who will wear the pirate shirt. We'll measure this shirt to make sure that the finished pirate shirt fits. I'm going to measure the sleeve and get about 22 inches. I'm going to measure across the body and then add a little bit. I was 24 inches across the body of this shirt, but for the body of the pirate shirt, I'm going to be about 30 inches across and about 30 inches tall. I'm going to end up with a square because this is kind of a wide guy. Here's the basic layout for the shirt. Now these are all big baggy pieces. The body is going to vary somewhat according to what measurements you've taken off the shirt, and the length of the sleeves will vary also, but you want those sleeves to be about 30 inches wide. The collar is going to vary in length, but it needs to remain about 6 inches wide. The cuffs are about 4 inches wide, and the two square gussets are each going to be 4 inches square. Those don't change. However, you can modify this in other ways depending on what you need. Now, if you want to capture a still image of this layout, it's available on my blog, which is listed at the end of the video. If you need that, feel free to make use of it. I'm going to draw my rectangular shapes directly onto the fabric. Then I will cut and just rip, and this way I can get a perfectly straight line. All right, so what you're going to end up with is two rather large, almost square pieces. This is going to be the front and the back of the body. We're going to have one long, narrow piece. This is going to be the collar. We have two cuffs. We have two underarm gussets. And we have a reinforcing piece for the center front. You may use one or both of these. You see how this used to be a square. Now these two pieces are the sleeves. And this is very strange because this is the length of the sleeve and this is the width of the sleeve. This is going to look very strange to a modern person, but sleeves back then were very baggy. So this is going to come out looking correct. Select one of the body pieces to be your front and cut a 10-inch slash right down the center of this front. After that, you're going to line your two body pieces up, and starting from the outside edge, you're going to sew 7 inches toward the center. So now you have a front piece with a slash down the front of it, you have the two shoulder pieces, and you have a back, which is just as you originally cut it, a basic square. This is the sleeve. This is the side where the sleeve is going to attach to the cuff, and you'll notice I've put on two lines of stitching all the way down the sleeve. For the purposes of this demonstration, the stitching is in black and white so that you can see it. When you actually do this, you should use a color that matches whatever material you're using for the pirate shirt. On the other side of the sleeve, the side that's going to attach to the shirt itself, I've put in about 12 inches of stitching. Once again, this is in black for demonstration purposes. We're going to use this to gather up the top of the sleeve. I'm going to show you how we're going to do this. I'm just going to take the two pieces of thread and I'm going to pull, and it's going to bunch up. Pull from either side. Now you have to be careful to either grab just the top edges or just the bottom edges. And we work this along. And we end up with this part of the sleeve being kind of puckered. Now I've done both sides of the sleeve. Now we're ready to put the cuff on. Have my cuff piece here, my pins. I'm going to line the edge of the cuff up with this first line of stitching, put the pin in. You always want to put your pin at a right angle to where you're going to sew with a sewing machine, because then you can just sew right over the top of the pin. You don't necessarily need to take them out. We don't have to get insanely picky about this, because this is a pirate shirt. If it doesn't fit the person that you're making it for exactly, well, you can just imagine that they stole it from somebody else now, can't you? Okay, we have our pinned cuff in place. Have our little ruffle there at the edge where we've gathered the material. I'm going to sew this. You don't have to sew it with a machine. Machines, of course, go a lot quicker, but you can sew this by hand, doing basically the same thing. When we've finished, we turn it over and smooth it out, and there's a nice gathering into the cuff. So here's my sleeve inside out again. Here's the cuff sewn. It's all pinned carefully. Now this is nice because we can sew one continuous seam all the way down the underside of the arm, except for the last 4 inches. We want to leave this section here unsewn. I have given myself a double pin here so that I don't make a mistake and sew too far. So here is the cuff attached to the shirt. I'm going to fold it up on the inside, pinned it in a few places to hold it. Take needle and thread. Going to whip stitch it, which means I'll take a little tiny stitch right here on the seam line. We can see through the fabric. Pull that up. Once again, turn it back just enough you can see where the stitch line is. Tiny little stitch like that. And we're going to go all the way around. You don't have to take very tiny stitches here. This is just to finish off the edge of the cuff on the inside. Now the cuff is finished off. Now we're at the other end, the part where it's going to attach to the body of the shirt. Here's my 2 pins, which show where I stopped sewing. This is the hardest part in the whole thing. We're going to take one of these squares of fabric, the 4-inch square, which was going to be the armpit gusset. I'm going to line it up along this 4-inch side. Pin it in place. Now, here's the other side. Just turn it right around here. Pin it up the other side. Remove the 2 marker pins. Now, I want to sew a seam right up to here. And then on the other side, we'll sew another seam right along that side. Okay, now I have the 2 lines of stitching. I'm going to take out the pins. Take the tip, and when I lay this out, we've got the gusset right here. This is the armpit. This place up here where we're going to gather, this is the top of the shoulder. Okay, the sleeve is now right side out. Got the finished cuff here. Got the gusset here. I put it on the person who was going to wear it and checked that I did not have this area too gathered. We want to make sure there's plenty of room in the shoulder. Once again, the sleeve is right side out. Here is the shirt body. Here's the 10-inch slash. We've cut down the front. And we've put 2 more lines of gathering around the back of the neck. So that's all set to go. The sides are completely open. Now we're going to take the inside out shirt and the right side out sleeve. We're going to put them together. There's the top of the sleeve. I'm going to start pinning this in place. This may seem a little counterintuitive until you realize that if you were to pull the sleeve inside out now, out through this hole, it would all be inside out. This is the secret to setting a sleeve onto a shirt easily, especially when you're using this 18th century pattern where everything is just rectangles. All right, both sleeves are now set into their places. The shirt's currently inside out. Sides are still open. I'm going to turn the shirt right side out just to show you what it's going to look like. And there's the sleeve set in. Here's the gathering at the top. Here's the gusset at the bottom. That is set in. So here's the neckline. Here's that 10-inch slash that we cut. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take this, I'm rolling it under two rolls so that the edge of the fabric is encapsulated. And I'm going to pin it as I go. All right, here is our front slash with the edges pinned down and sewn. You see there's kind of a mess here where the V comes together. And what's going to happen is we're going to go to the outside and place this over that area and hand sew it down. All right, we have the front reinforcement sewn down. This is all stitched up the front. All we need to do now is take the collar and attach it to the shirt. I've marked the center back of the collar. Centered back of the collar, and I've pulled up my gathering so that we're all scrunched up in the back. The front is just open. I'm going to start pinning here. I'll leave a little bit of extra on the outside edge because I'm going to want to hem up the raw edge on the collar. And I will start pinning. Going around the corner where the shoulder is attached, it's going to be just a little bit tricky, but you can lay it down and do it. Okay, now here's center back on the collar, here's center back on the shirt. We are going to make sure that those match, attach them together, and we'll take up our gathering. Pulling on the strings until these two lay very nicely together. See what we did there? We pulled on our gathering strings, made the back of the shirt smaller so it matched the collar that we had previously cut. We're going to do the same thing on the other side. Here's the edge all pinned. Still have these black gathering threads in here. We'll take those out later. Once again, the black was only for demonstration purposes. This is very gathered right here. And now it's going to be a simple matter of sewing a straight line around this edge, and we'll have our collar sewn on. So we have the collar sewn on all the way around. I'm going to turn these edges down. I'm going to turn up the inside here. Put it together and pin it. And this is going to go just about the same way we did on the cuffs. Okay, I have a closed side here. I have this finished edge all the way around here. As soon as I sew this down, I'm going to hand sew this again. And then our shirt is basically finished. We have to sew up the sides of the shirt, which I think you can probably do on your own, and we have to hem the tail. And after that, this shirt is finished and we've made an 18th century pirate shirt. And there we have it, a finished pirate shirt. If you've enjoyed this video, please feel free to check out my books, Scarlet Sails, Gentlemen and Fortune, and Bloody Seas, available in Kindle and Amazon.